major cause of dead zones is an increased nutrient load in our waterways. Excess nitrates and phosphates that come from human activities are the most significant contributors to this problem.
Ashlan here at the Annapolis Maritime Museum, and we are going to learn how to test for nitrates and phosphates.
We start with the nitrates.
This is our quick sample. So Ashlan, can you measure 15 milliliters
of
the day?
Now AJ gets to add a solution and zinc.
Shake vigorously for 2 minutes.
So why do we even test for nitrates?
Nitrates are important because they give nutrients to the bay. But if there are too many nitrates, it creates an algae bloom.
In the next step for measuring nitrates, I'll add another solution.
8, 9, 10.
Perfect. And this amphire, you're gonna stir it in here.
This is the easy sample snap vial for nitrates.
And then you're gonna pull this part towards yourself and it's gonna break. Perfect. Invert that for 10 minutes. First, we have to clean off the fingerprints. AJ, can you put it in here? And then push it in. I'm gonna cap it and press go.
All right, so our reading is 0.02 mg over L. What does that mean?
That actually means milligrams per liter. For every liter, there's that many milligrams. So this is relatively low for the nitrates in the water, which is great. It's not gonna promote growth from the algae bloom.
We were talking about nitrates and phosphates, so we need to also check for them, correct?
Of course, phosphates also come from fertilizers, but they're more common in detergents and cleaners, which also run off into the bay. So we want 25 milliliters, so can you pipette that?
Now we need to introduce a solution and shake it.
And can you invert it for 3 minutes? And then can you cap it and shake it for me? Our 3 minutes is up, and we can now test it with this. It's a spark meter. Again, we're gonna clear it for fingerprints, and then push it in there. Cap it, and if I hit go.
It is 0.29 milligrams over liters.
So this is a little high for the bay, but it's still healthy. It's not detrimental.
Thanks you guys so much. And this is how to measure phosphates and nitrates using Costco equipment.